Spooky.
Without further ado, it's time to get right into the spooky, scary game. So I'm just gonna switch over to the normal scene, the one without the going live. You know, I'm gonna do something completely normal. And oh my God! Man, that scared me. My heart is racing. I think I'm gonna die. I need to call an ambulance. Drugs are not, unfortunately, the end goal of this. But they are, you know, sometimes it's about the journey, not the destination. That's what that's why I take drugs, you know? It's about the journey, not just the destination. Sometimes, in order to get somewhere, you have to get high. Get ready to screen cap in 3, 2, 1. Sorry, I'm entering my hamster phase. Actually, that probably makes my sister flinch if you can see me. I'm doing the little, you know, the little fucking hamster thing. That, you know, you hand them a little bit of carrot, and they're gonna their two little teeth going like a fucking wood chopper, but it's a carrot chopper, or a CC for short. And if you've got 10 of them, then it's 10 CCs. Ba-doom-tsh! Funny band reference from like the 80s, I think. 10 CCs. Fun fact. Their name. You know, many. Have I said this on stream before? I feel like this is a thing I've said on stream. Is this the hospital? No, it's the apartment. Okay. But it's the same thing. This has the same vibe as the hospital from the first game. So I feel like we're gonna be here a fucking while. And so it's a good thing that I got the map. Just saying. Anyway. 10 CCs, right? People go, fun fact, the 10 CCs got their name because that's the average amount of semen in a male ejaculate, or an ejaculate. Hashtag support our trans queens out there. You know, 10 cubic centimeters or 10 milliliters are the average ejaculate. That's wrong. Actually, the average ejaculate, shout out to my trans queens out there, the average ejaculate is 4 to 6 cubic centimeters. 10 cc's actually got their name from, the band couldn't think of one, and their like producer or whatever had a dream where he saw a billboard to, I think it was a bar or a cafe, and he walked towards it, and it had the cafe or the bar or whatever it was called 10 cc. And that's where they got their name, from a dream that the producer had, which had 10 cc's in. Actually, so, get fucking got? Oh, this is gonna be so fun. Oh, this is gonna be so fun. Oh, this is gonna be so fun. Oh, you have no idea how excited I am for this. This is gonna be so. Okay. Oh. Now I'm just disappointed. There wasn't even like a halfway decent jump scare, and it had nothing to do with all of the mannequins. Now I'm just disappointed. Shit could have been fun, the mannequins could have come to life, we could have had a fucking thing of like, oh, if you're not looking at the mannequins, they move, you know, we could have had a fucking weeping angel kind of shit, that would have been fun, that would have been exciting, I would have had a fun time, you miserable piece of shit.
He's close.
Oh. What? That's it. You needed a whole cutscene to so that your guy could go, these clothes. Like, wait, I'm piecing shit together. Okay. James, terrible name, miserable name. Every man named James would be sad and miserable and hate their life, right? You know who else is sad and miserable and hates their life? The majority of eggs. He sees these clothes, conventionally feminine clothes, a dress and a lovely pink cardigan, and he goes, these clothes. He's thinking to himself, you know, there's no one else here. It's just me and the clothes and the mannequin and the occasional goopy guy. You know, I'm completely outside of societal influence and standards and expectations. I could finally live like myself. I've worked it all out. Every step of the process, I've worked it all out. James... Mason, whatever her last name is trans, and if this isn't enough, like you know, she still doesn't put on the clothes now. We need to call in the Force Femme Brigade. Someone Force Femme this man now. Like all of you know how like the Matrix is about. Being freed from the gender binary and like being like, hey, this miserable world that you know is fake and you feel off about and everyone acts like it's normal is wrong and there's something else out there and it's gonna be hard and you have to fight, but you're gonna be so much freer and so much happier. That's what the Matrix is about. It's a trans allegory, right? Silent Hill 2 is a trans allegory. It's like, what if you wanted to be happy and be a woman, but God said, creepy guy? Oh, okay, big ups. Oh. Small ups. Very tiny ups. I mean average-sized ups. Every man has ups that are this size, you know. Very normal-sized ups. Really? How fucking weak are you? I don't work out. My arms are noodles. I'd still be able to get up this fucking height. Like it's not even, it's like barely head height. And you've got this beam that you can stand on. You grab onto the ledge, you put your feet on the beam, you work one foot up and then the other. It's really fucking easy if you're not in like a dress or a skirt. Which, hey, you're not. Unfortunately, but luckily for you, that means that you can survive the spooky monsters. Silent Hill 2 is a game about how society, even in a situation where the pressures of society are void, the expectations of how to act and how to what your gender dictates, make it safer to escape the scary monsters. This is all about how being trans will kill you even in a situation outside of societal pressure, because society is so perverse and pervasive and is everywhere. And how we need to change society at its core so that people can be happy without homicide cases. I've worked it out. This game is telling you that sometimes, to survive the spooky monsters, you've got a boy mode. And that's wrong, and that's bad, and we need to make it so that you can survive the spooky monsters and be comfortable in your body. I'm a genius. Honestly, I'm joking. But, like, straight up, why the fuck not, you know? Why the fuck not read it as some form of transfeminist literature about the society? We live in a society, Batman. We live in a society, Batman, which doesn't let me wear a dress. The Joker, if it was based. But like for instance, it's not the original intention of the novel, but it's very easy to read 1984 by George Orwell as a piece about you know, homosexuality and that kind of shit. You've just gotta be like a mega brained size brain. Cause like, yo, hi, welcome. You're just in time for literature class, I guess. So, 1984, right? The main premise is a forbidden love story. I wonder which other relationships were until very recently forbidden love stories. Queer relationships. They think they're the only ones fighting against this oppressive society, which removes their language and controls them and removes them from the media and... Oh, hi, Spooky. No. Sorry, Spooky, you die now. Anyway, they finally find a secret society of like-minded individuals. You know, finding an underground gay scene. They finally have hope that they can survive, that they can change society to allow them to love in such a society. And for their relationship to be accepted, and for, you know, their language to be unchanged. And then it turns out that, you know, all the secret society they found was a trap. That one makes slightly less sense, but, like, you fucking get what I'm saying. I'm trying to make a, in my opinion, very good point that 1984 by George Orwell, as well as being, you know, a seminal text on authoritarian state and surveillance states and the panopticon, etc., is also about, well, not intentionally, but can be very easily interpreted as about homosexuality and living in a homophobic society. Furthermore, the things that Winston says about, I think his name's Brian or O'Brien, in the novel, are so gay. When I did it in, school, everyone burst out laughing when we read some of the descriptions that are of O'Brien, because there's no heterosexual explanation for the way Winston talks about O'Brien. Fucking hilarious. George Orwell's 1984 is about homosexuality, and Silent Hill 2 remake is about being a trans woman.
Hey, wait.
And yes, I'm insane. But no, I'm also correct. Thinking of biting away my pride and getting an emulator, but my DS is... Walter White sticker, I think you are legally obligated to use that forever and ever and ever and ever. And if you don't, then, like, that's illegal, and, Walter White himself will come and turn you into meth. Which is true, he does that. In the tie-in, movie, Walter White's Big Day Out, he runs into trouble with some guys who play a little prank on him, and they turn his they mess up with his meth so that it turns into just crystal instead of crystal meth, and in retaliation he plays a prank on them by turning them into meth. It's a great scene. One of the best scenes that Vince Gilligan has ever directed, I think. And so every single Walter White sticker has a part of Walt's soul in, and if you neglect it, then he'll, turn you into meth. So this is my warning. Don't get an emulator. Use your DS at least once a day, or else you'll be turned into meth. Brother loves to draw. He was the one who made the sticker. Looks like Walter White, but as Kermit the Frog. That's even more powerful, you know? Kermit the Frog is a force of good and love. And so if you mistreat him, then the universe itself will turn against you and try to destroy you. It's true. It happened. His song, It Ain't Easy Being Green, is actually, in a sense, a bit of a lie for him personally. Not metaphorically. I imagine the song is true metaphorically. But for him, it is very easy being green, because if someone even calls him, you know, someone says, you frog it, then the universe will kill them. Or worse, like they might live their entire life just completely sad, unsatisfied, etc. And a bunch of other shit. Kermit the Frog is loved by all. Thank you for the unwielding wisdom. Already banged a hole in my wall. Look, I'm happy to help, you know? Any time of the day, assuming I'm streaming, you know, I'm here to dispense wisdom from on high itself. For instance... There you go. That was a little piece of wisdom. And if you heard nothing, then you're just not enlightened enough. You're not tuned in to the true frequencies, which only those who are going to escape samsara can hear. Anyway, the wedding dress. I bet Miss Mason would love to put on a wedding dress. Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? This entire The rest of me playing this game is just going to be making jokes about force-femming Hammer Mason. Leaving children to just like slowly die builds character. It's like the Spartans, you know, that when the boys turn like 10 or something, they dump them in the woods, you know, live on your own for a month, and if you survive, then welcome back to Sparta. Otherwise, you die. That's what we've got to do, you know. Society went downhill when we stopped dumping children in the forest to survive for a month. That's the real issue, you know, with like global warming and deforestation, etc. I could care less about the orangutans. But those children need a sufficiently large forest with enough dangerous animals to survive in for a month in order to become adults. This is what is wrong with our society at its core. Always break the thing for the fire hose, because you never know. You never know when a goopy guy is gonna lunge at you, and you need to like wash the goopy guy. You know? There's nothing worse than a goopy guy, which is just like, you know, a non-moist goopy guy. If your goopy guy isn't moist, then I don't want him. I want only the moistest and dankest of goopy guys. There's gotta be a goopy guy in here somewhere. I've checked everywhere except for the bedroom. Am I gonna get lucky? Is there gonna be a goopy guy in the bed? Oh, no goopy guys in my bedroom. Fuck my buck alive. that sign can't stop me, cause I can't read. Okay, that sign can't stop me, but that lock can.
Ooh. You know what time it is. It's time to kill some goopy guys. I'm the monster now.
Just your average creepy old guy standing on the balcony pointing a gun at the passersby.
Get off my property! Get the fuck off my property! I'll kill you!
Get off my lawn, guy, but he's got a gun. get off my lawn. Yeah, sure, Grandpa. What are you gonna do? Pulls out gun. Get off my lawn. Oh. Are there any wet guys here? Are there any moist men? Are there any, damp dudes? Think about how wet the average person is. And then think about how wet the average cadaver is. Dead bodies need to be wetter. Vote for me for president 2024, and I'll make dead bodies wetter.